Hey everyone, Liam here, and welcome to this match preview and prediction for the match between Yannick Sinner and Ben Shelton in the first round of the Vienna Open. Let's get into it. Long time no see, but before we get into the video, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you enjoyed the content, it really helps us grow the tennis section community. There's so much content coming onto the channel, not just predictions. You know, if you go back, I've got so many practice videos from the US Open and other tournaments I've been to, vlogs from those tournaments, shorts as well through many different aspects. And also, I'm going to be going to more tournaments both this year and next year for you guys. So there's going to be so much more content coming onto the channel. So please subscribe if you haven't already. We've got a very exciting matchup, obviously, here between two players who met recently in Shanghai, and you know what, that was a great matchup there, and I'm hoping to see a great matchup here in Vienna as well. Obviously, Ben Shelton is coming off the back, you know, just having won in Tokyo, and you know, getting his first title under his belt in his first ever final, which was great to see. Obviously, that first set against Aslan Karatsev was very tight, 7-5. But in the second set, you could tell that mentally Karatsev had lost it. And, you know, Shelton just didn't take his foot off the pedal. He was hitting the ball super hard on anything. First serve, second serve, he was just getting the ball right back at Aslan's feet, making Aslan having to move a bit uncomfortably around the court and making him hit a lot of unforced errors, which was great to see. And I'm very happy to see Ben Shelton now. I believe he's in the top 15 in the rankings. He has even potential, you know, if he manages to get another big title under his belt, maybe here in Vienna, or goes far into the Paris Masters, you know, he could be in contention for a lot of ranking points, getting him closer to the top 10 in the rankings. Maybe, definitely, probably not enough to reach the ATP finals, but definitely close enough to reach the top 10 in the rankings, which for a person who was 96th in the world at the start of the year, just turned pro last year after the US swing, it's great to see from Ben, and I'm very happy to see that he's playing some of the best tennis of his career, especially after the first half, up until the US Open, where he hadn't really won back-to-back matches on the main tour, other than his quarterfinal run at the Australian Open, and then his semi-final run at the US Open was great to see. I think coming into this one, Yannick Sinner will also be looking to get a little bit of revenge coming into this one, just because, obviously, we saw Yannick win, beating Alcaraz and Medvedev back-to-back in Beijing to finally sort of take the curse off of the Medvedev head-to-head and get a title under his belt, and also qualify for the ATP finals in his home country. First time he's qualified, technically qualified to the top eight. Obviously, he'd already played there as an alternate due to Matteo Berrettini's injury, I believe, in 2021. But it's definitely a proud moment for him. Obviously, he's been preparing very well to play at his best and peak towards the ATP finals. He has played extremely well even beforehand, so it's going to be interesting to see what sort of level of tennis he's trying to play here in Vienna and in Paris, whether he's going to try really exert too much energy from his game, or if he's really going to be just trying to fine-tune some things in these few weeks heading into the ATP finals to then have enough energy and play at his best in Italy in front of his home fans. I think coming into this one, obviously, the head-to-head is 1-0. They did meet in the round of 16 of the Shanghai Masters, but that was straight off the back of Yannick Sinner's win in Beijing. He won in Beijing, flew or took the train or whatever, straight to Shanghai, had a bit of a, you know, had to get used to the new conditions, and Ben Shelton obviously came back from a set-down in that match against Sinner, and it was a great match. I mean, it was just popcorn match written all over it. And this one is going to be a little bit different, I think. If this was a matchup, you know, in a week's time, maybe I would say it'd be another extremely tight match. But just because it's a matchup a couple of days right after the Tokyo final for Ben Shelton on the other side of the world, in conditions which, obviously, you know, they're indoor hardcourt conditions. Tokyo is still an outdoor event, technically, and indoor hardcourt conditions are going to be a little bit different. Yannick Sinner's probably been already there for a fair few days, practicing, getting himself into the rhythm, getting accustomed to the conditions. Ben's going to have to arrive, get used to the jet lag, get used to the conditions of the court, and play a match all right from the get-go, which is going to be quite hard for him, I think. Obviously, it's his first year on the tour. He had a good amount of time to get himself into the Asian swing. Now, to get himself back out of the Asian swing, he doesn't have that much time until his first match. So I think Yannick Sinner is going to be able to capitalize on that one. And the fact that he won the first set 6-2 against Ben Shelton in the first match shows that, you know, he can beat Ben and he can play extremely well against Ben. Definitely he's not going to be a dominant head-to-head one side. I think it's going to be a quite even head-to-head. But I think the conditions here and the fact that Ben's not going to be at his fully rested or at his full best because of the jet lag and the travelling, I think Yannick Sinner gets himself the win and gets himself into the second round here in Vienna.